Right on. Thank you.
Thank you, dear. Take care. Nice to see you, Beth.
Thank you for the present.
Oh, my pleasure. Do I?
Yeah.
Chicago. Chicago accent.
Okay, that's right.
Wait, we don't have an accent in Chicago, do I? Nice to meet you, Mark.
Mark, man.
Nice to meet you,
man. We may see you around.
Yeah. Am I supposed to get in there?
We're all getting in now.
We have the constant debate about foot. So do you have dry socks in or something? Or
No, I just got Polypro and wool. Believe it or not, my feet stay dry the whole trip.
Really?
I'm a hopper, yeah.
Okay.
Nobody does it better, Captain Mark. Hey, Charlie. There it is. That is the coolest thing.
It's fantastic every time. It's fun to watch.
Look forward to it.
Yeah.
I hope you have a safe trip. Or leave no trace. And I'm sure we'll be picking up after people.
Yeah, we will.
Kind of comes with the territory.
Yeah.
Kind of caring for the area.
Where are you going?
I'm going around the corner.
Probably the same place, Mark. Probably going to see the same.
Oh, good. I'll catch up to you. Okay, guys. We'll see it. You too.
Drop by on iron if you you want to have a drink.
I will. I'll look for you.
You don't want to come in over the edge?
Safe trip. No, you guys are fine, man. That's what that boat was made for.
We got a whole 2 inches of...
You guys, I'll be honest, I'm a little jealous. They're going to be living the high life.
We are living the high life.
This is an easy trip.
Have a good trip.
We're just heading over to those two flags over there. Well, there's... Is that the... Did you say that?
So here we are on beautiful Lac La Croix, and just starting out, first few minutes of paddling here, and it sure feels good seeing some people, and we would have to expect that. A lot of Quetico paddlers have been displaced, but I have a feeling that we're gonna like the boundary waters too. Thank you. this is the big opening that I've been waiting for. I've been kind of tacking in and out of these small islands, heading generally easterly. Just pulled over to take a little stretch and adjust the gear a little bit. Gonna go right into that corner over there. Found a nice campsite. It's a really scenic spot here. There it is. Love it. Just getting situated here, getting set up. This gorgeous campsite. Tomorrow we're gonna go south, right out there, and bam, continue to skirt the border and get in the Iron Lake area. Well, today's the first morning in the park. Got to bed at about 8:30 after a long day of paddling, and woke up at 7 o'clock. Always a good night's sleep up here. So, gonna pack up camp here. Probably be on the road by about 9:30, a little bit late, but we slept in this morning. Gonna paddle up to Bottle Portage, portage into Bottle Lake, and then around over near the Iron Lake area. This is a new adventure for me, camping in the Boundary Waters. And I'll have to say, these fire grates are really nice to have. There's always a latrine, that's a good idea. Wow. I have seen it all now. I'm sitting here getting washed up, just brushed my teeth. I look up and here come a couple of guys paddling on the standing boards, and they've actually got all their gear on the boards. I've never seen anything like it. Check this out. Just leaving our first campsite. And here we go. Heading straight east into the sun, and then we're gonna hang a hard south. Gonna go straight south toward Bottle Portage. Some pictographs here somewhere. Barrier Hill. First portage of the trip. Not too bad, huh? Final trip of this portage. Got out of that portage, paddled across the lake here, and I'm gonna get situated, grab a quick lunch. And what do we have here? Reference mark. International boundary. So, here's the U.S. And there is Canada. So we're gonna grab the next nice campsite we see. So we're in the narrow part of this little arm, and it's really almost like a little river. It's got a little bit of current. We're going against it. But the big thing is, there's a lot of boulders right below the surface that you can't see until you're almost on top of them. So really got to watch out here for this. Yeah, very, very hazardous here. Lots of rocks that you can't see until it's too late. Ooh. There's one about 8 inches below me. I get to this place where there's a big drift of boulders across the waterway. I'm going back and forth looking for the portage trail or the path around this thing, right? And then all of a sudden, I see this. Water's just a little too low. So, the final turn in the opening into a whole new lake system. This one called Iron Lake. Seems to be a very popular spot based on the number of campsites marked on the map. Wow, gotta really be careful here. I just hit a boulder. It basically grounded me. A nice big flat one, but man, oh man, with the sun the way it is, can't see a thing. Look how calm it is back here. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to fight that wind all the way across the lake. Just give me this beautiful calm any day. This is home. And I think I can see, straight ahead there. Looks like there's some nice rock formations over there we could go hiking on. I like the look of that. Here we go. Let's hope it's a keeper. I like that it's got a little bit of exposure to the sun here. Park. Look at these tent pads. Home sweet home. To me, this 5-star. First light on Iron Lake. Now we have the challenging task of finding the food packs. I hide them in the night. Got this new jet boil. I really like it. And as you can see, I just turned it on. So you'll notice there's some color indicators right there. boiling, baby. How do you like that? So on my way in, I ran into a gentleman who approached me and he said, "Hey, I know you. I've watched your videos." And then he told me that he actually went out and bought a Winona Encounter Solo and rigged it up just the same way that I have mine rigged. So that really brought me a smile, because the purpose of this entire endeavor is to share information and encourage others to take part in this great tradition. That didn't take very long, right off the campsite here. Let's hope it's a dinner walleye. Nah, it's a northern. Anyway. Pretty tough conditions here. Trying to maybe find a walleye or so. Here's number two, hopefully. Literally right in front of the campsite.
Lots of garlic and tomato. So we're gonna basically have a walleye Italian garlic gumbo with a tomato base. I'm gonna go prepare the main course. Just leaving our site here on Iron Lake, heading across into Crooked Lake via Curtain Falls. Should be into Crooked by early afternoon. Gonna fish our way there. Sun's just coming out. Straight that way.
We're just coming up to the end of the lake here, Iron Lake, where it's gonna go off into Curtain Falls. Gonna take a look over here. There's a portage and I gotta see how to get to it. Looks like I gotta pull over right here. I could walk this, pull it right through there, paddle up there, and there's the portage. Okay, we're gonna put on the water shoes and walk it. Finish the first trip of the portage. Here we are. Curtain Falls. So this is where Crooked dumps into Iron. Think there's some fish down there? That fish yesterday, tell us the story.
See this little cove, the back of the cove, little reeds back there, weeds coming out about 15 feet. Put it right in front of the weeds, bring it in, and it just slams it. And as soon as it slams it, it just kind of, it's shallow. It's probably 2 feet there.
Yeah.
And it just kind of flips its tail, and I'm like, oh boy! And it just goes, whew, and turns my canoe to the left, and I yell at that, I'm like, it's pulling my canoe!
Gets the net out, and it swims back. He tries to hit it, and the thing had so much fight in it, it just came back, and just at the right time, he scoops it up.
He lifted out of the water.
Yeah.
All I could say was, yes!
It was awesome. Right in the boat.
The lure. Yeah. The lure was
the lure
coming out. That's the one mounted under the picture, for sure.
And the amazing thing that you haven't mentioned is you were in that little solo canoe.
Solo canoe. It's smaller than...
Oh, yeah.
You look down at me, and I'm just like... He goes, you're shaking. I'm like...
Yeah.
Right, like,
that's called major adrenaline.
Just that feeling.
So I ran into those guys at the waterfall. They told me that there's going to be wind gusts tonight from the northwest. So I chose a campsite here. Okay, so I got this new Primo sleeping system. Here it's gonna be 20 degrees tonight, so we'll test it. But basically, it's a complete system that essentially ties into the air mattress. You can make it from a mummy to a bed. And then this hood goes over your head. And then there's a beautiful pillow right here, and you don't slide off the air mattress. So low 20s tonight, and I wake up and it's gonna be hard to get out of that bed. Beautiful. It's the morning after the cold night, supposedly got down into the 20s. So today's gonna be just a lazy fishing day, creeping across crooked. Creeping across crooked, capturing creatures called walleyes. We've got a gorgeous morning. Calm, a morning after a 20 some degree night. Tell you what, slept like a rock. So here we are, just making out on our way. So we're gonna go all the way east across Crooked, veer south into the Basswood River. So here we are on Crooked Lake. You know, a lot of people think this is some of the best fishing in the park. And scenery is stunning. Weather is perfect. And, kid you not, it just occurred to me, because I had to look at my watch to confirm it, but it's my birthday. Happy birthday to me. There's no place else I'd rather be. Though maybe I wish my wife was with me. Tiny northern. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Here we are in Thursday day. We continue our trek. Thank you.
Here we are on that easterly passage. This is about as narrow as I've seen the border. Look at that.
Stretching in. Once in a while, gotta get out of that boat and stretch those other muscles.
Always nice to see what's going on at these other places that you might someday need. Look at this, wow. So I grabbed a little flat rock here along the Basswood River as I paddle south towards Wheelbarrow Falls and other moving water that's going to necessitate a long portage. I think it's around a mile. Thank you.
Okay, here we are coming up to the waterfalls, the big lookout. So let's see if we can get the view here. There's the falls. Here we go, into the Basswood River. It's gonna be a big portage day. Look at this big, beautiful oak. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that. That's about as big of an oak as I've seen in here. Look at that. Nice. Right along the river. That seems to be where they grow best. Here's another one. Look at the size of this one. They kind of get bush-like out here. It's funny. What do we got here? Beautiful red oak, huh? Look at that. Look at that. Look at those oak leaves. Beautiful or what? Look at that. A wild Northwoods oak tree. How old that thing must be. Darn, look at that. Oh, love it. Okay, here's the end of the portage. Kind of step down onto that rock. Dump the boat. Wow, what a nice landing. Look at this. Beautiful. This is really a beautiful trail. Look at how flat and straight that is. It's actually 20 minutes each trip, loaded, and then 15 empty. Thank you.
I'm rereading a Sigurd Olson book of time and place, and he talks about Jack London, and one of Jack London's writings is about men who don't fit in. There's a race of men that don't fit in, a race that can't stay still. So they break the hearts of kith and kin, and they roam the world at will. They range the fields and they rove the flood, and they climb the mountain's crest. Theirs is the curse of the gypsy blood, and they don't know how to rest. We're out here now, heading into that opening to the east. Out of the wind at U.S. Point. We are right here. Here I am, right here, heading all the way up to Prairie Portage, straight east, right where you see that wall there. It's funny, I just put the camera out, and then I noticed there's a panel. Sitting here at the dock, sending the spot signal. As soon as Donna gets that, she'll call Bob. Here's our guy.
Hey, big guy. Look at you, always right there at the ready, on the run. You guys are a bunch of hustlers. Nice driving, Luke. I love the way you guys come whamming through those turds. You know exactly where to go.